In this video, I'll show you how to find the reference angle for each quadrant. To start off, I want to call this quadrant 1, quadrant 2, quadrant 3, and quadrant 4. And what I have is a Cartesian plane with angles ranging from 0 all the way to 360 degrees. In question 1, they ask, find the reference angle for 125. So our angle exceeds 90 degrees, and it's within this quadrant, quadrant 2. Whenever you have an angle in quadrant 2, you either have to subtract that angle from 180 degrees or pi. In our case, we're dealing with degrees, so we'll subtract 180 minus 125, both of which are in degrees, and that gives us 55 degrees. So 55 degrees would be your reference angle when using trigonometric functions. In question 2, they ask us for the reference angle for an angle that is 236 degrees. So this time, our angle will exceed 180 and be in quadrant 3. According to this, if in quadrant 3 you have to subtract the known angle from 180, therefore for question 2, we'll take 236 minus 180. Notice the difference between this and question 1. In question 1, we took 125 from 180. 236 minus 180, that gives us 56 degrees. In question 3, they ask, find the reference angle for 331 degrees. This time, our angle exceeds quadrant 1, 2, and 3. It's actually located here in quadrant 4. Whenever you have an angle in quadrant 4, you subtract the known angle from 360 degrees. So for question 3, we'll take 360 and subtract it from 331, and we end up with an angle of 29 degrees. That's your reference angle. And finally, find the reference angle for 15.5 degrees. 15.5 degrees is in quadrant 1. That itself is the reference angle. There's no need to do any further calculation. And so there you have it. That is how to find the reference angle for each quadrant.